they don't, I mean, they will pick up on that in zoning code, I'm not saying that they won't, and this, I'm using kind of a simplistic term, so I'm trying to determine. It could be a sign, somebody comes in and says, how big a sign can I put on the side of my building?
And then.
Inspection firm is not gonna know how big a sign that they can put on the building.
I think one of the perhaps, and perhaps rather than look at the, those little details, perhaps on a more global basis, for example, when a zoning application or a rezoning application comes in, or a request for a special use permit comes in, something more global as far as the use of the property, and questions in that regard, so if you've got a developer coming in who wants to make a proposal and says, hey, can I do this in the, in this, you know, what's the current zoning for this property, and I'm looking at putting in a, you know, a petting zoo, can I do that in the R3 district? And so, you know, that's typically not something that a building inspector is going to have, you know, real, you know, clear knowledge for, obviously, petting zoo's an absurd example, but, you know, they're not gonna have the more global policy kind of decisions that entails in looking at the code and saying, oh, zoning, yes, this, type of thing, and so that, it's not unusual to split them up, but again.
So this does not eliminate the variance committee?
No.
No, it doesn't eliminate.
If somebody says, well, I still wanna do it, you still have the ability to take it to the variance committee and then have it come to.
Right.
Correct.
Yeah, so they still, no, all the same, so in fact, so the statute in that regard would pick up a decision by not only the building inspector, but also by the zoning administrator, so the fact that you've broken them up doesn't hurt anyone's appeal rights, they're still the same.
All right, so that's what my point is, that's not one singular person's decision.
No.
No.
So I think what's getting me is that if you look in that, under zoning administrators, that section one there.
Yeah, it should say that the city administrator shall serve as a zoning administrator, there's a, that's a.
Right, I think that whole, the building inspector shall serve as a zoning administrator and shall enforce provisions of this chapter and such purposes he shall have, or shall have the powers of a police officer. The duties of the zoning administrator shall include inspecting premises, issuing building permits and certificates of occupancy for buildings and use of lands that meet the requirement of this chapter, does that all get eliminated out of there then?
So it would have.
So he would just be, this would just be an advisory position to the planning commission and the aesthetic.
So no, they would still have, so he would, they would still enforce all the provisions of the chapter, that a zoning administrator would, and would still have the powers of a, when we say the powers of a police officer, we're not talking that Mark's gonna be wearing a badge and carrying a gun.
And he has five positions.
But from the standpoint of enforcement action, so the zoning administrator does have enforcement authority with regards to, for example, issuing citations. And so, you know, when we say the powers of a police officer, it doesn't have to.
That's already been changed and given.
Yeah, exactly, that, we did that earlier, early last year, as far as expanding the authority with regard to.
But he's not gonna be going out, and we don't want you going out and doing that because you don't have the time and that.
No, I've got a code compliance officer that's gonna be doing code compliance, I have a building inspector, which will be doing all the inspections, and then the zoning administration portion of it, when I get somebody that has a question on whether this is a permitted use, I will be doing that interpretation and then giving that information to either the code compliance officer or the building inspector, so it really will be a team effort in doing this, rather than just having, like we have today, one person.
And I guess that's why I refer back to that, just that in red, the zoning administrator shall serve as an advisor to the planning commission, aesthetics control committee, and common council concerning zoning matters.
Right, so when you have a question on zoning, I would come to the planning commission and I would say that under M1 zoning, this is the proper permit, it's a permitted use by our zoning code under section whatever, that would indicate that this is a permitted use, or I would say this requires a special use permit under the zoning code.
Right, we don't want you issuing building permits and.
No, that's done by the building.
Right, so I think.
I mean, that's all in here, and I think this is what's causing.
So I think what we can do is, we'd rephrase it to say, the city administrator shall serve as a zoning administrator, period, the duties of zoning administrator shall include, but are not limited to serving as an advisor to the planning commission, aesthetic control committee, and county council concerning zoning matters pertaining to the city and shall perform such other duties and responsibilities as set forth in this code. I think that encapsulates what the intention is, and then, you know, then we don't need the language as far as, you know, the police officer, again, from the enforcement standpoint, that's already otherwise established.
He's not gonna be inspecting, you're just gonna, somebody comes in, we need somebody here at the city.
This position's just gonna be an interpreter of the code.
So if somebody comes into the city and says, hey, I wanna put this business in wherever, whatever piece of property.
Yep.
You're gonna look at the zoning code or zoning map and say, well, it's either permitted or it's not, and if it's not, here's what you need to do.
Right.
Yes, and most of the time I'll be consulting with the city attorney if there's a question on whether, you know, the permitted use is something that requires either rezoning or special use, or, because all those resolutions or ordinances have to be written by the city attorney.
I think the way you reworded it, it's much more clear.
Okay.
Absolutely. Janice?
Well, have to be very simple on the first one, first ordinance, just to put where it says the building inspector shall serve as zoning, instead of the word shall, may serve as zoning, so that we don't have to refill the whole thing in case we get an inspector later that will be doing that, and just put the word may. You're just editing one word in that one, and in the other one, it's pretty confusing, unless it's just gonna be stated very simply that temporarily, the city administrator would be interpreting the zoning.
What do you mean in the other one, Monique?
In section 105-12B. So the first one, if you just put the word may, then you don't have to repeal the whole ordinance, it's still there in case we get a full-time inspector, or an inspector does do it.
I don't think we want the buildings to be doing that anymore.
I think that's the point that's trying to be made, is we shouldn't have been having the building inspector and the, acting as the zoning administrator as well.
It'd get better, so it'd be better to deal with developers if you split them up, and because just so happened Craig was unique with the 30 years he spent here that.
The word may just allows them to, it doesn't mean they have to.
I mean, I don't have a problem, is there an issue with that?
The only issue is that the duties and responsibilities are identified, and if you're not clearly identifying which position is gonna be the zoning administrator, I think you're gonna run into problems in enforcement of the zoning code, because there's.
Paul, what's the legal definition between shall and may?
May is permissive, shall is mandatory, so if you say you may do it, that doesn't mean that you have to, it means that you can.
And shall is mandatory?
Shall says, you know, shall would be equivalent to must. So, you know, if you make it permissive, then it's essentially up to the executive, thou shalt not steal, so that's mandatory.
If I'm reading this correctly, then the city administrator would then, along with the powers of zoning administrator, gain the powers of a police officer?
No, we took that out.
Okay.
I'm not asking for that.
Yeah. We took that out,
that's all.
Okay,
so you don't have to worry about that.
So my other thing, and this is, I don't know, just kind of, I always think about worst case scenarios, what could possibly go wrong, right? Now, could the city administrator, who also happens to be the zoning administrator, because we are making it so, conceivably declare that the barrel company is operating within its zoning rules? And so if the citizens disagreed with that judgment, ruling, interpretation, exactly what recourse would we have? And because the city administrator is not elected, and so we can't recall or vote them out. So there would be literally no, what's the word?
Any ruling of the zoning administrator.
Accountability for a wildly unpopular decision such as that.
Any ruling of the zoning administrator can go to the council.
Okay. The zoning administrator by statute is gonna go to, and the decision is gonna go to the zoning board of appeals.
Well.
Any agreed person can appeal the decision of the zoning administrator, the zoning board of appeals, is set forth in 16.
But only the zoning board of you have to have a vested interest toward the zoning board appeals, you couldn't just be a citizen.
No, you're an aggrieved person.
Okay, so, there is
checks and balances there.
Yeah, it's not a final, it's, any decision is not a final decision, it can always be, can be either challenged by the zoning board of appeals or.
But the zoning board of appeals makes a decision based on whatever the facts they have, and that decision is final.
That's fine.
But it's also subject to appeal to the circuit court, as, by statute, so the zoning board of appeals, you know, that has a review, oversight provision as well. So, and it's not, you know, let's second guess them type of thing, it's limited to essentially four separate issues, did they stay within their, jurisdiction, did they, you know, did they correctly interpret the law, so there's finite types of things that a court would look at, the idea is that the court's not supposed to substitute their opinion for that of the board of appeals, but rather to see, did they, you know, make a rational decision based on the correct law.
Now, I absolutely agree that this, zoning administrator should be split from the inspector, however, I disagree with placing that type of power with the city administrator, because there's not accountability.
I guess, to me.
Doesn't make the final decision, they can take that decision to the, board of zoning.
And he's an advisor to the planning commission.
Which is the county, which is members of the county council.
He's an advisor to the aesthetic control committee and to the county council.
But then.
So, there's no expansion of the powers beyond what the building inspector currently has for the city, so we're not, you know, there's no.
If anything, I'll use the example of Mid-America Barrel, cause he used the example, in all likelihood, the loading dock that was on the back of the building, we would have looked at it differently if two sets of eyes would have been looking at rather than one. So Craig interpreted it to say, okay, you built the loading dock, this is what you need to do in order to get the loading dock.
Under the building code,
where I would have said, this is a legal non-conforming use, you can't necessarily add a dock onto a legal non-conforming use, I would have consulted the attorney and made a determination that we need to look at this further. So if anything, it would add more of a check and balance, I think, to what he is, indicating than trying to let them get away with something. I think that we've got a better chance of not doing that. My experience has been that I did this for 7 years, so I mean, I interpreted the zoning code, I was the zoning administrator, I got that experience. So based on me as a person, again, this is, you're looking at this as my position, but me as a person, I'm certainly capable of doing this. I think if you do it with anybody else, whether you do a planning, have a planning firm do it, or an attorney do it, it's gonna end up costing us a lot more money that I think is unnecessary. I mean, again, these are just interpretations of the zoning code. And again, there is checks and balances in the system to, so it doesn't give me any additional power. It actually makes me closer to have a better understanding of what that business is and what it's doing as the city administrator to be able to say, wait a second, staff, we need to look at this a little differently because maybe it isn't in accordance with the code.
If I can make a further suggested modification to 455, and in light of all the discussions here, why don't we just, so part of the issue, again, keep in mind, we're not carving anything in stone and bringing it down a mountain or anything here, but for, so if this doesn't work, for whatever reason, or if the situation for the city changes in the future, you can still change the code to facilitate that. Again, part of the issue here is that with the 455 ordinance is that it's in the zoning code, we have to take it to the planning commission and we have to take it, have a public hearing on it. There's really no need to have to do that. I mean, you could change 455 so that it just straight up said, the zoning administrator shall, and then just rely on your language in chapter 105 as to who is designated as the zoning administrator. You don't have to designate in two places. It creates a, you know, the original referral to me was with regard to 455, and looking at the code is like, well, if we only change that, we've got a conflict. So it's quite possible if you go to change it in the future, someone might catch one but not the other, in which case, there again, you have a conflict. So to eliminate the potential, you know, in additional work in the future, should it want to be changed, you can change the zoning, you know, the 455-55 and just say the zoning administrator shall,